In this tutorial, we will see what are angular inputs and outputs. Friends, there are some scenarios when we are using nested components. That means we can see a child and parent relationship between components. So in that kind of situations, you need to pass the data from parent to child or from child to parent. So if you see here, input decorators used to send the data from parent to child, whereas output decorator is used to send data from child to parents. So these are the two decorators from Angular core we are using to send the data from parent to child or vice versa. So assume this is the scenario that we have a parent component and we have a child component, and you need to pass the data from parent to child or from child to parent. So this kind of situations maybe came on your application. So while doing the application, you have to use Angular inputs or Angular outputs. So first of all, we will see how Angular inputs are working and how Angular outputs are working. If you see here, I'm using inputs and outputs behind, or you can say nearby child component. This is why, because we are importing this input and output in a child component only, and from here using property or event we are passing and getting the data from parent to child. So let's see how we are using inputs. If you see here, I have divided the steps into two parts. First part, in child component we need to use input, and after importing input you need to declare a variable within an array set, or that can be multiple or can be one. Suppose here I have taken one value with child data, and I need to send a data from my parent to this child data. If you see, I have imported the selector, child selector, and I'm passing this variable here in the child selector, and I'm passing the data from parent selector. So if we do practical, then we will understand it properly. So let's go and implement this. So this is my parent component. If you see, I have already one component, parent, that assume it is a parent component, and I need to generate a child component. So I will just generate a child component, and I will give the name as child. So my child component is generated. So for style purpose, I'm taking this one only, and I'm putting it into here, and let me rename it as a child component. So how to make nested component? You need to call the selector of the child, and you need to inject it inside parent component's template or view. So if you'll see, the child component is here. So for your better understanding, I'm changing the color. I can give it as a, okay, fine. So this is how we are doing nested component. Now it's time to share the data from parent to child. For that purpose, if you see here, first step tells us to import input and then to declare the variable. So go to child component, here bring input, and within this component decorator you need to pass inputs with an array, and with this array you can pass multiple values. I'm passing here, suppose child data, it's a variable name, so don't be confused, child data. And what I will do, I need to bind it on the components view, because we can understand properly that it came or not from parent. Data from parent, okay, and paste it here. So currently there is no data in the child. So what is my task? I want to get the data from parent, and I will need to show it here within child component. Now come to your parent component. So currently there is nothing. So what you need to do is, you have seen I have declared the data here, the variable, just copy it, go to your parent component, and within the selector pass it with square braces, and here you need to pass the variable from the parent component. So let's just define a variable in parent component. Suppose here I'm giving parent data, and I'm putting it as a hi, I am from parent. and I'm just passing this data into the child components variable, or you can see this is my child component variable, so I'm just passing my variable here. So once we have passed here, you can see my data is available. So this is how we are passing the data from parent to child. Or also in runtime also you can pass it here. Suppose I have an input, and what I am doing is taking val. This is a reference type, so no need to worry. Input, and I am calling a function like send. Here I am passing val.value. So what I will write here, that should implement here also, right? So for that I need to define this variable, sorry, this function. Suppose this is the val parameter, and here this dot parent data equals to I am passing as val. Now let's see, you can see whatever I'm typing, it is impacting here also, right? So this is how we are passing data from parent to child. In next tutorial we'll see how to pass the data from child to parent using outputs. Thank you.